I had a plan. And it was a good one. I was gonna just fade away. And you know, everyone fell for it. Everyone fell for it. I had succeeded in fooling everyone. Except myself. I thought that, yeah, okay, it was gonna be hard to leave people that I loved. But it wasn't hard. It was impossible. Especially away from her. I didn't realize how much I needed her. How much I absolutely needed her. I went up to her when she was walking along in the park. And I just sort of whispered her name, but she didn't even turn around. And then I said her name louder, Adora! She turned and saw me and stood frozen, almost thinking that I was something that wasn't real. I walked closer to her and said, it's okay. Still, she didn't say a word. She just kept staring at me like she was going mad. As I got closer and closer, tears started filling her eyes. I said, Adora, I'm real. I tapped her on the shoulder, and as I did, she fell to the ground, started sobbing uncontrollably. I grabbed her and I held her as tightly as I could. I'm so sorry, I said. I'm so sorry that I did this to you. But I'm back. I'm back. I told her my plan, my attempted plan of how I didn't want people to look at me and say, Atticus, fix this, Atticus, fix that. I didn't want that. And so instead I wanted to fade away. And she said, well, you're not fading away from me. Not ever again. And I agreed that I would stay with her for the rest of my life. I took her back to my parents, where I got to share the news with them too, that I was alive. I talked to Zales and Poseidon, to Arania, to the kids from Mexico. And we promised, I had everyone promise me that this would be a secret, that I would change my name, that I would just be a normal person in society until I left for the stars. For my children in the skies. But I would live a couple years here in the world, on the planet, with the people that I love. The people that I loved. I was so glad to see them again. So glad. Well, there was stuff that I needed to do to sort of entertain myself. I was gonna stay. I'm talking with the family and my friends. I agreed that I was gonna stay here on the planet long enough to get married to Adora and to sort of let them make a decision whether they wanted to join me in flying off to this planet, these planets, where all my children were and others as well. So I had to make myself busy. I had several years to stick around. I think, thinking back on it, I think it was 10 years that we decided that I was going to stick around. And so during that time, I didn't want to just laze around and do nothing. Adora suggested that I use my magic powers, my metal powers, to like develop technologies and just say that I was a inventor. But sadly, I told her that I didn't have any powers left. Now, when I woke up from my last mortal wound, I woke up without any powers whatsoever. And so I decided to do something that I had kind of wanted to do, especially since leaving Mexico. I wanted to be a teacher. And so that's what I set out to do, to become educated, to acquire a certificate, and to become a teacher, and to live a normal life. And that's what I did. I ended up marrying Adora. I got through my college, my university. I got my education to be a teacher, and I became a teacher. And let me tell you, the teachers I saw when I first stepped into that role, they made it look so easy to be a teacher. So simple. They just stand up, music starts playing in the background, and kids magically started learning. And so I thought, that's so easy. So I decided that's what I was gonna do. And let me tell you, it was easier being hunted after by 1 billion soldiers than doing that. Trying to be a good teacher was hard. I stood up, I played music in the background, and I started teaching about 2 plus 2. And little did I realize that it was a lot harder than it looked. And for years, I learned and learned from the best teachers how to do the very best job. And all the while, living a normal life, going home, seeing my wife, getting to talk to my parents, talking to Zales and Poseidon, and of course, Urania. Now, you probably have figured this out already in the story, but of course, the very first person that had agreed to immediately go to the planets with Atticus was Urania. She absolutely agreed. The other people who finally decided to go after several years of processing it. Oh, and I should say, I mean, of course, this goes without saying, she married him for crying out loud, but Adora was going to be going too. I just realized I switched from my first person to the third person again. So I'm sorry. Those of you master storytellers, I apologize for messing this up on you, okay? Am I Atticus or am I the storyteller? Can you tell? Maybe I'm one and the same. Who knows? Anyway, Adora decided to go with Atticus. Of course, she married him, so she decided that was going to be something she would do. As well as Urania, of course. Zales and Poseidon finally decided to go, and Zeus actually decided to stay, which made Atticus's parents make the very, very tough decision, but they decided that they were going to go for a little while to visit and then to come back and stay on planet Earth. So that was a very difficult choice for them. But the people that decided to go, of course, nostalgia too. She wanted to go back to her home planet. And Zales and Poseidon and Urania, Adora and Atticus would eventually leave this planet and move back to the three planets. On one of the last nights before they left, Atticus was cleaning up his classroom, and he was all alone, and Adora decided to come and surprise him. And what happened was that Adora was the one who ended up being surprised, for as she walked into the room, she saw Atticus was blindfolded doing the thing that he used to love to do, which was making little robots and building little cities. Atticus! What are you doing? You said you didn't have any powers. Honey, darling. Oh, I'm so sorry. Maybe I do have my powers still. And she's like, you lied to me. Why would you do that? And Atticus is like, I'm sorry. I just thought that maybe one of you guys might accidentally tell someone and all of a sudden the world would know. And then if they did, then I just want to be known as this guy who doesn't have powers. I don't want to be known as a hero. I don't want to try and save the world anymore. I did that once. I just want to live a normal life. She's like, this is a normal life? And he's like, no, come here. And he started explaining how every time he made these little robots that they would replicate and they would eventually create a civilization or a society that would get so big they'd split up and they'd have these wars. And so he was sort of drawing Adora into this current war where there was like a giant city, a little metal city spilling out over the table of his desk, and then there was another giant metropolis city on the floor off to the corner, and then there was a third city that was near the door. And you know, these three cities already had developed flight technologies and were sending bombers off to the other cities and things like that. And Adora says, why do you think that is? And Atticus is sharing his opinions and things like that. And this is the point in the story where you would actually, it fades out, and this is where the credits would roll, because this is now truly, truly, not joking anymore, truly the end of the first adventures of Atticus story. This is the very end of it. So, really, really hope that you liked it. Oh, there's like a whole bunch of music stuff going on. Sorry about that. I hope you really liked The Adventures of Atticus. The first book, The Adventures of Atticus. Are you going to focus again? Are you going to focus? Probably not. Okay, well, that's fun. I hope you enjoyed this series of The Adventures of Atticus, book one. And if you're interested, if you like this and you want to hear more about Atticus and his pals, then you can tune in on Wednesday for book two, Adventures of Atticus, Reign of Doom. And I hope you enjoy that one just as much as you enjoyed this one. So sorry for this fuzzy ending. Maybe it's the camera thinking that you're supposed to roll credits now. So anyway, thank you so much for listening. Have a great evening, and we'll see you with a new story of Atticus on Wednesday. Bye-bye.